What's up guys, Sal here. So ARM has officially announced the CPU and GPU cores for 2023, which will end up on devices like the Galaxy S23 Ultra. These cores will be used by Qualcomm and Samsung on Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 and Exynos 2300 respectively. So let's take a look at this new CPU cores that are even more powerful than this Intel laptop silicon. Starting with the most capable CPU core, the Cortex X3 Prime core is 25% more powerful than the X2 core on the latest flagships. ARM even says that this X3 core offers 34% better performance than Intel's Core i7 1260p mid-tier laptop CPU, which is impressive considering we're talking about a smartphone CPU versus a laptop CPU. So basically, the Galaxy S23 Ultra can outperform the P cores of the Core i7 when running common application code. Some of you would say we don't need this kind of power on our phones. But you see, things are changing in the smartphone world. Smartphone technology has become so advanced that the phones really are now mini computers. You can do most of the things on a phone that was only possible on a PC just a few years ago. I agree phones can never replace PCs, but the point is, they are increasingly becoming more versatile and can do most of the work a PC does. The best example is DeX, which literally mimics the PC, allowing you to do things on a bigger screen with a keyboard and a mouse. And this is one of the areas where you definitely appreciate the increase in power. Now, a lot of you would say impressive indeed. But what about the battery life or efficiency, because that matters more? Well, even though it's 25% more powerful than its predecessor, it consumes less power for the most part. But when you start pushing it to its limits, it consumes more power than the X2 core as per this fake graph shared by ARM. The second new CPU core announced was the Cortex A715, which is a mid-core, and the gains here are modest, just 5% to be exact compared to its predecessor. But the efficiency gains are massive. It's 20% more efficient than its predecessor, and considering most of the day-to-day apps use this core, it will translate to a big win for battery life. ARM also mentions that this core can achieve the same performance level as the Cortex X1 release in 2020. Now, ARM didn't announce any new little cores. They tweaked the existing little core, Cortex A510, to make it 5% more efficient. With that said, neither Samsung nor Qualcomm use ARM's Mali GPU, so the improvements here don't really matter. But the new Mali GPU finally supports hardware ray tracing similar to the new AMD GPU on Exynos 2200. This video explains the ray tracing. Basically, it's a graphic rendering technique used to better simulate the way light illuminates a scene. Look at the reflections and soft shadows here. It provides quality improvements in in-game graphics. The fact that now Mali GPU also supports it would mean game developers will finally start offering ray tracing in their games. Qualcomm is the only one that doesn't offer ray tracing, but I'm positive that will change with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2. Of course, for all the latest updates on the Galaxy S23 Ultra, be sure to subscribe. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.